Good morning and welcome to another exciting episode of DDOwiki Talk with your host Technical13, aka ShoeMaker. Not sure what we're going to be doing yet this week. I am hoping to be able to next week split the 2-hour DDOwiki Talk into 1 hour of DDOwiki Talk here on DDO Stream and then 1 hour of Lotro Wiki Talk over on Lotro Stream channel on Twitch. I put up some stuff in the Discord and on Wiki itself to get feedback from the viewers of the show and the community. So far, everything has been positive to go ahead and go for it. So I'm going to try to get that ready and put together for next week. I guess let's hop right over to the Wiki. See what we can edit this week. I have no idea where we are. I'm halfway through my first cup of coffee, which I just poured and like drank half of it in one shot. Take a look and see what we got. Second cup. Feel free to come join me in Discord voice chat on the DDO stream channel. Live stream channel of DDO stream. Also, feel free to check out DDO Wiki Discord channel. Have any wiki editing questions? Happy to help people with those there. Alrighty. Pop out this chat box real quick. Shuffling things around. All right, I gotta set up hosts. Throw the splash screen back up for a second here. Here and go. My channel.
Well met.
Morning, MREF. Looks like we're getting some people this morning. Ready, so I got those hostings all done.
Well met.
I got to adjust my Twitch. Let's see here.
Well met.
Right. Not my Twitch alerts, that's Jerry's. Okay. So, I'm not going to worry about that right now. Drink this for a minute. And screenshots for that go there. My desktop? Really? Really? Okay. Here, last semester, good morning, Elf Maiden, So let's get this up here. Let's see here. Let me blow it up there for you. You can actually see it. That can go away. Load. Last week's. Set. Apparently that's not going to work, so I need to remove one, add one, alrighty, so today's prize is going to be 500 turbine points, and we're going to need 9 people today. We'll go with M.A. Mayquist. Not what I want. Add attendee, and then we'll go with Amaref. Now we're up to 2 out of 9 already. Let's save this. Good. Go to the folder that has all of this with the titles here. Add some titles. Sort by date. This is that was episode 30. Let's see here. Which episode are we on now? Aren't I horrible? Stuff, DDOwiki talk. Let's bring it up on the playlist. Last week was episode 36. Down so you can see it normal. Last week was episode 36, so this is 719. Then episode 34. We didn't do one for episode 35, right? That's episode 36. I really should change it so I can set the name. This would be episode 33, episode 32, episode 31, 36, we skipped episode 35, March 8th have been, somewhere between 21 and 30. When was episode 21 was February 23rd. March 22nd, technically, so 29, this is probably 22 and 23, 22. Alrighty. There. Now I've got all of those saved. Good. You can find the complete playlist right here. All 36 episodes, I believe. Although I do need to merge together episode 2 still. Episode 3 needs to be renamed. Nope. Episode 1 and 4 need to be renamed. Ah. Those aren't local. Those are on Dungeons & Dragons Online, so I need to upload those locally. Rest of them are there. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Special episode 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Rest of them are all there, week by week. Alrighty. Then you can check out the shoe cobbles and insert build here. One or more removed from the plays because they were deleted from YouTube. Oh, good. I have to figure that out. 1, 2, 3, 4. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, four, four. Strange. Potion of Wonder for the win. That's a pretty awesome video. You should check it out sometime. Can't hear it. Anyway. Let's check out the recent changes here. Oop, lost our chat box. All right. Go back here, August 1st. That would have been the day before. I've been doing a lot of late nights working on stuff. Working up through. Here we go. Template work in progress. All right. I remember now what I was doing. Kind of. MM Missing Phantom, we worked on. For category game bugs, we'll take a look at that to see how it turned out. Oop, that's minor game bugs. I want regular game bugs. Pages in category. Ah, that's where we left off right there, I think. I was working on making it so that I could have it so that it would give me a list, a count of all the sub-pages. And I actually did get that completed. I was very excited. Category Monster Manuals. This is it being used. Then I did some filling in some hirelings. A huge project to be worked on. I did some work to the template tab. Template div call. I did some stuff there, I guess. Updated some documentation. JJ Zab did some TB override stuff. Our title blacklist to be able to prevent some invalid file names and pages and stuff like that. I created a bunch of redirects and worked on. Oh, where was the page? Video store sales. I worked on that page. We now have edit notices for user and user talk. I'll show you what that's all about. Talk edit notice. I did a whole bunch of stuff adding pages for AutoWiki browser, so people can semi-automated edits. If you have a large project that you want to work on and you want to use AutoWiki browser, I'm starting to set up documentation and whatnot for how to do that on this wiki and permission sets and whatnot. I created a search template, which is very, very basic right now. I created user example, that it would be protected. Some protection. Template work in progress stuff. I want to show you guys, because that's pretty cool. MediaWiki gadget work in progress. I did a first revision on that, which I can show you. I haven't tested it in Chrome yet, so that'll be interesting, something interesting to do today. Did some bug stuff, template DDO bugs, something I created. It's just a link to the bug reporting thing in game. Or bug reporting website for the game. Instead of having to type out ddobugs.turbine.com every time, you just put in ddobugs as a template. I created some templates for different colors, like green and gray and purple and orange and whatnot. There I want to check out. JJ replaced some Tempest stuff, rune stuff with Zorian runes. And then we're up to today. So let's have a look here. What do we have? Game bugs, okay? So I pulled this out of there. That should be commented out. As to not poorly show up in there. Page history, October 2013, edit. Scroll down, like this, comment this out. On other pages. That'll remove that listing. See that we got our 184 known bugs. They've all been fixed. There are some that are blank because of the way that they're transcluded. I still have to figure out how to fix that. Hide this one. We have minor game bugs, which lists all 44 minor game bugs. Are not listed in the bug section. I don't know if the template categorizes as both or not. And then I added a new section for missing from Monster Manual, which there's 77, which is what that subcategories of pages and thing is for, so that I could count that. Each, because each missing monster manual is categorized by its missing MM type. It's not lumped into missing from monster manual. So what I did is I did it account by type. Every subcategory of missing, of monster manual / missing. And you can see them all sorted there by type, pages. Some of them count as something else, or do not register because you don't actually kill the monster. That was something I was excited to actually get put together. This is an awesome page here. I know if it's a work in progress anymore. Yeah, I still have a couple little things I want to take care of. Pages in category. I had to add this whole section here. Count as false. Oh, so I changed the dash to a false. And then I put this new chunk of code here that's in blue. If equals sub only one, loop index from one to the number of pages in category of whatever category it's asking for. We've already defined page count as page count plus pages in category one slash explode DPL category, whatever the category is, format. Give me a list of titles. Basically, it says, give me a list of pages that are in this sub. Give me a list of subcategories in this category. Fix this real quick. And then go through each, explode, take that list and chunk it up into sections, which is what the explode is. Makes a like an array out of it almost. And then pull each chunk of the array and one by one count each one and add them together. And then output the total. Pretty clever combination of using loops and variables and string functions and DPL to create that. Took me, that's what I was finishing up last week, if I remember correctly. Awesome. And that's, and this is what the result, this was a resulting DPL table for that. Above table lists all 77 pages and the following 26 subcategories. I think I actually counted that out at the end of the stream before I killed it. Pretty great. Template tab, I changed it from going from the number of points to, oh, I actually changed it some more. All right, page history, that was from there. So from four, from the number of the input point to expression of the input number minus one, because we have a non-breaking space at the end over here. So that's the minus one, so we gotta take that last space off. The number of spaces they want, minus one, times 8px. I found that 8px per character is much closer to an actual character width than one point per character, or 1m, or any of the other measurements. The only problem that I have with this is it won't scale up very well with different font sizes. So I still need to figure out how to make it one space worth of div for every number of spaces that they request. But I'll have to figure that out later. I'll do some more research on it. Div call, I did a little bit more documentation. Well, not really. I just cleaned the documentation, so that doesn't really help much. All right. DDO store sales. So I added this DPL table here. Let me compare it so you can see what I went from. So completely modified it there and there. I got rid of the underlinked. It's now linked. I adjusted the formatting to use month, day, year, because that's what the majority of our wiki users use. I made the table sortable. I made it HTML5 compliant by adding the word color in there for background. And then we just went from this raw table to using a template, DDO store sales history row, date, percent, and then a list of items that were listed. Still needs a little bit of work here, but it was this big, huge, long table, and I converted it to use templates, and the result is date, savings, items, and each item is actually a link to the item. Now that I've done this, I've got a few more redirects to make and whatnot, but now that I've done this, I can go through and I got some blanks to fill in. Looks like it hasn't been updated since January, and we're in August now. What is this week's sales? Ah. Morning, Mayquist. I didn't know you were in chat with me. Usually what I do is I mute the stream, or I recommend that people, when they join me in live chat, mute the stream and keep Discord unmuted. That way you can actually hear me in real time without the 30 to 60 second delay, and then you can respond as well. All right, so freebie, the sale this week is Um, 25% off Select Storage, Slayer Boost, and more. Slide this over here. That in there. Let's actually go up here and edit this this page. Add this week's sale. Here's the sale page, Select Storage, Slayer Boost, and more. If we scroll down, it'll actually tell us. Scroll down. So, that's kind of cluttered looking, isn't it? All right. We're going to go like this, close our template. Today is August. This is August. Is that week ending or week start? Date. I don't know. January 15th. Let's take a look here. Yeah, I said that like 5 minutes ago, man. You're behind. 2016, and it's going to be, we skip the date. Oh, August 5th. They would go by the date. I'm guessing that they go by the date. There's the August 4th, maybe. All right, I don't know. I'll have to figure that out in a minute. So 25% off. 25%. Item 1 equals item 2, item 3, item 4 equals, okay. Treasure Hunter's Elixirs. Fortune. Select shared storage. Slayer count boosts. Now I just got to figure out the date thing. So January 15th, what day of the week was that? January 15th was on a Friday, and sales go from Thursday? What? Oh, So the 11th. Okay, so Tuesday through, or Thursday through Thursday. So if that was posted on a Friday, then it's probably the 14th through day before, so the week of, so we'll call it the 4th. Okay. Say August 4th, start of the week. And I'm actually going to go up here and update the header for that. For date, it's going to be start date of sale. All right, so we're going to add 6 weeks here. There we go. Select shared storage. Shared bank storage. It's going to go with what it says there. All right, so the other thing that I want to do is I want to Yeah, they do. Not a problem. All right, so I want the Wayback Machine. Archive.org. I want to see what archives there are for this. Apparently there were some in March, one in June. So let me go like this. Let me save it now. I lost the E. All right, let's try it now. Saving page. Great. I can find some of them on Discord as well. If I scroll back, every week I've been updating the MeBot key for that for the last month or two, and I should be able to pull up what it was from that. Or, well, no, because that only lists a summary. Video sales and promotions, huh? So it's year, month, day, and then a timestamp UTC. I wish it didn't have the time that it was updated. All right, so I'm going to add one more parameter at the end. Yeah, the plus more is the part that's going to kill me. Archived equals... paste. And then if we edit the row here, I'm sure somebody has a list of everything that was on it. I might even be able to convince Cordovan to give me some of it, if possible. Ooh, I know who I can send a request to for that. I bet I can get Valero to come up with something for that for me. Alright, 35 captures, I want to bring that up. Turn my fan up a little bit, I'm not really hot, just a little bit warmer than usual. I don't like it when my temperature color and my indicator goes to orange. Even if it's on the low side of orange, just light orange or yellowish. All right, so August 4th, somebody took a snapshot on August 4th. I want to look at that. I want to look at June 10th. This one. Oh, two snapshots that day. And this one. Patterns. Can figure out what the patterns are, Amref. That way you can say when... So the whole purpose looking at the history is so we can figure out what the future likely will be. Good morning, Titan. Running a little bit late this morning, but I see that you're here. Yes. I will add you to the list. If you win, I will reroll. You won the last time, or... fairly recently, so we'll give somebody else a chance to win, but I'll add you to the list there for others. Who else do we have? Anybody else show up in chat yet today? Let's see here. Some people have been here but not talked. I see some people are here that aren't talking. I see Dean's lurking in here. I know Jerry just leaves it up in a background screen, although he might even be on IRC. I don't know about Dino in IRC. But I see some other people not talking yet this morning. Maybe they'll talk. We'll see. Crank that down. Alright, so this was last week's. Oh, cool, they caught it before it was updated. Awesome. Um, 35% off last week. So what I want to do here is for number one, I want to put a ref, if equals archive, what did I call it? Did I call it archive or archived? Archived. If archived. Not empty. No, if it is empty, skip it. If it's not empty, ref Plane link. Archived. We'll see what that should look like in a minute. Save that, slide this over. Has not been added to any categories. I gotta figure out a way to make a tool to figure out what proper categories would be. Anyway, let's copy this. This one, March 4th to 10th. Okay, so this is going to go on the other end. We're going to start here, which is July 29th. July 29, comma, 2016, 35%. Item 1, item 2, item 3. Item 4, archived. Get 1, 2, 4, 5. We'll put 6 of those in there. About the dates real quick. Oop, not on the last one. That one's right. Drop out the percents too. Get the archive links copied. Copy. Paste. June 10th to the 16th. Copy. June 10th. I put that in the wrong spot. Paste. Let's move one up here. Why is it doing that? I hate it when it does that. Yes, lurkers. Lurkers everywhere. Set in there. There we go. This one up here. Nope. I don't want that. I don't know why it's doing that, but whatever. The next one. Oh, what was the percent on that one? 30? 30%. And then the next one is 20% March 25th. 20% March 5th. You know what? Let's chop all of this out of here real quick. Let's open this up. Paste it in here. Turn off word wrapping. Trigger so you guys can read it. Scroll up to the top. There we go. Much easier to read when it's one line per. All right, so March 25th. The next one is March 11th, and it was 20%. March 11th, 20%. March 11, 20%. I forgot to copy the archive link for the other one. That went twice. I can dump that 4th through 10th. Copy this one. Paste. Then the next one after March 11th is March 4th, and it's 35%. March 4, 35%. Archived. All right, so let's see here. March 4th, 11th, got two for that one, so 4, 11, 18, and 25, so there should be four for March, right? Ah, I'm missing the 18th one. Drop this out. Put it here. Turn the word wrap back off. So March 18. That will be link for the 24th. While we wait for that one to load up, I'm going to slide it down to the end. This one, June 10th. What were the items for June 10th? Select monster manuals. I made the July one go away. I need to bring that back up. I'll get that in a minute. Slayer count boosts. Then there's not going to be an item 4, because the last one is companions and name change. Oh, it is creature companions and companion name changes. So I guess I will make that an item 4. I had it as one item before. We'll copy this up here. So it's going to be item 3 and 4. I got it down here too. What do I have on Wiki though? Oh, I didn't make the link for that one. Okay, that's good. All right, so what do we have here? That one I'm all done with. I can go up, back. Up, back. Ex Orta. You know what? I haven't added you to the giveaway yet. Can't win TP if you're lurking, man. Add you to the list here. Save. All you have to do is say something to be added. And I wanted the July 10th one. This one. That's the one that I want. The one that was taken before it was updated. Uh-oh, my coffee cup's empty. So it's 9 o'clock. This would be the point where I would be shutting down DDO stream and loading up Lotro stream for Lotro Wiki Talk. Does anybody think that this would be too short of a period? Or would this be okay? Or what do you guys think? Your feedback is what's important as to whether or not I do this. The fact that I was banned on Lotro Wiki for being, for, you know, contributing templates that show external links from trusted sites like the official forums and internal links that have to be rendered as external, as internal links. Silly, silly stuff. Apparently the host of the site is all concerned that people are going to be messed, taken advantage of. I've been doing it on DDOwiki for, what, 6-7 years now? And it hasn't been an issue, so I'm not sure why he's so concerned about it. Wikipedia itself has links styled as internal links that point to other sites that aren't on Wikipedia itself. I don't know. I have no problem with it if that's what they want to do, but they need to give me a clearly defined list of, you know, what's what and discuss it. I mean, it's really not an issue, but whatever. Nice fresh cup of coffee. Good morning, one man. I see you're coming out of the dark. Let's add you to the TP code giveaway here. 728. And save it. All right, so July 29th through August 4th. I think I already had the archive for that, didn't I? No, I didn't. Okay. Copy. Archived. And March 18th. Oh, that's not the right one. I need the March 18th one. March 4th through the 10th. Oh. All right, let's copy last week's. I'm just going to copy all of these like this. And I'm going to go like this. Oh my, blows it all up. All right, so item 4, 3, two. All right. So last week's July 29th is all done. Oop, I forgot my equal sign. That wouldn't have been good. Item 3, item 4. So I can dump that. I can close this one. Close March 25th. No, not yet. Okay, so March 25th. I need to copy that one. Oh, this is going to be a 20 to 50% off week. March 25th is 20, 50% off. I'm actually going to get rid of this. That for now. March 18th. 25th is done. Oh. March 25th is done. Now I need March. I think. Oh, 24. Let's go to the 24 there. That should be before it was updated again. Okay, so the 11th through the 17th was 20% off. Ooh, 5 items. A minute. Something's out of whack here. History recently closed. Eleventh through the 17th. Ah, right here. Okay. Paste. Parts of wood. Item 2 equals. Item 3 equals, 4 equals, item 5 equals, okay, that one, March 4th through 10th. Equals. March 18th is the one that I need now. Interesting. It was updated early that week. All right, so apparently I don't have information for that week. All right, I guess I'll have to dump that row. All right, so. Copy this and see if there's any more item 3 name changes. Right here, so like this, control H, and I hit normal, and I hit paste there, placed all 3 occurrences, cut, close, paste. Go preview. I gotta modify the archived link to not show the double square bracket things. web.archive.org. That's too much. Archived. Preview. I don't like the way it looks. Fan style equals font weight normal. Let's see what that looks like. Oops. Font size. It's too small. Small at the mall. Font weight doesn't seem to have any effect on it. Already in a span. Okay, so that will work. I should add it. A thin space and... Oh, that's right. Okay, so... Should add a thin space. Can I add a thin space? The reference template. I'll add it to the CSS. I don't know if that'll push it out. I'll have to play with it. Formatting. Tab index, not even worth trying. Do this. That doesn't show it at all. Going back to that. All right. That's good enough for now. I don't want to keep messing with it. All right, so let me bring up that Wayback Machine again. Let's see here. It says there was some stuff in 2015. That one and that one. Add the archive links for them. In the meantime, a new thing that we have on user and user talk pages is the ability to put up edit notices. So if you go to your user talk slash capital E edit notice, right, you can create some text. You can see, hello and welcome to my talk page. If I post on talk page, please respond there. I'll be watching it for a while. If you start a conversation here, I'll reply here. Unless you request otherwise, here on your talk page, so please watch this page. Start a new discussion at the bottom of this page. And then a couple of user boxes, my user signs post, my donations, and no personal attacks. So if you click on this link here, or the edit link on my user talk page. Oh. Oh, I'll have to fix that. Oh, it escaped my characters, which I didn't want it to do. Really? Well, I'll have to fix that. Apparently, JJ made something that breaks things. So if you go to my user talk page, you can see that this banner you saw on the other page shows up at the top of my edit page. Make the user boxes go away. So you create a new section. This is what's supposed to show up. I'll have to fix this on the edit page. But yeah, the edit page, now you can put a notice at the top saying, giving a little bit of information. If you start a discussion here, I'll finish it here. I'll always respond on your talk page, whatever. Unless you ask otherwise, type of thing. / edit notice. Edit page. Oh, that's why. All right, so I need to edit the edit template. I can't. So I'll have to create, pull it up on my account. All right. Grab this right here. Cut this out. Head over to here. Paste it. Scroll down. I'm not going to bother blowing it up, but what I am going to do is I am going to add if EQ semicolon namespace. Actually, if namespace equals talk space, if it's a talk space, and if equals IO new, and if they use the parameter new, then append pipe section equals new. Actually, we're going to do it section. Otherwise, make that a lowercase section. I know you can't see this very well, but if equals IO zero one section. All right. Closes the new, closes the talk space, so talk space if section. If it says section, section equals lowercase section, otherwise new is new. Section equals new. Close the if new if section. That's going to need some more work. I need to update the documentation, but I'm not going to worry about it right now. Back over here, and equals true. Page. On this. There we go. Now it works. All right, template search. Search for term home. Just a simple template that will let you put in something for a search query. I had to get a little fancy for it so that you could select namespaces because I needed it for something specific. I don't think it's actually used anywhere yet. It allows you to put a little search link on your user page for search for this query in namespaces this and this. You can only select one namespace right now. I need to add a bunch more logic to that. Right now, it's just if namespace whatever is true or namespace equals whatever namespace, then add that. I can get rid of a bunch of these right here. And Now, these right here, and just put in and explode and pull out the pieces of that. I could make a variable within a pseudo array of namespace numbers. Let's have it parse from that instead of doing this each one individually, just do a loop with all 15, 16, 17, 18, 20, 22. It's 22 namespaces. So I could just have it do a loop 22 times. With a list. Oh, I could have it do a loop 11 times and have it do both the talk and the main space, which are just one off. At 25 minutes, I might work on that. All right, so template work in progress. I did some work to this. Oh, I didn't want edit. I wanted history. August. Okay, we'll take a look at what I did there. Here's a gadget I worked on. A lot of work stuff here. Really technical JavaScript. I'll show you basically what it does in a minute. Copy this. Pick a work in progress page at random here. Potions and Kendra, I guess. Open up hirelings, go to the hirelings page itself, list of hirelings, control F, Kendra Esselson, that's what I want right there. Edit. So, go to list of hirelings, we can copy. Description. Project for somebody to do if they're bored. Copy the description. We got Mark and G. Update those later. Gold seal level is 5. HP, spell points, list of commands, we can copy these. Oh, good morning, Edward, I didn't even see you there. Then, drag this down here. We will be doing a 500 turbine point giveaway at the end of the stream if we have enough people. These out. Eat that. Copy these. I don't know how that'll render that. But it will do it. Awesome. Cleric. I have another idea for this at some point. I just haven't gotten to it yet. The only thing I have left is race. It's human, right? Copy this. Populated with data from list of hirelings, just fill it in. Got one man, 728. I already have him listed, but I don't have Ed in there yet. 6 of 9, we need 3 more people to say hi in chat in the next 20 minutes. Alright, so now that we've got this filled in, cure serious wounds I don't have an icon for yet, lesser restoration, cure light wounds, and divine vitality 1. Yeah, I need to work on that too. The pop-up isn't quite right. I need to work on the template that populates this, but all of the information from that page is here. So, get to here, and Control-Shift-J, right, for the console. So, I go here and I copy this. Aw, man, it's got this template on it. This article is a work in progress. I forgot to take that out. So, import script, in comes MediaWiki gadget work in progress. This will be a gadget that you'll be able to enable. It will not be enabled by default. You'll be able to enable it from your preferences section in the gadgets. I will add it there. And what it does is all the work in progress templates, it will add this little mark as done button to. Click on the button. Nothing happened, right? Wrong. Reload the page. Hey, where'd that template go? Take a look at the page history here. See DDO stream removing template work in progress number 1 from page. And the template's gone. It removes it. So it's a script that removes a template. If the parts that I still have to work on before I make it live is if there is a person defined to be in touch with for this, it's also going to post on their talk page. And I'm going to make it so that it'll first check their talk page, and if on their talk page, if their talk page is in category prefers work in progress emails or something like that, it'll send an email instead of posting on their talk page. Or maybe I'll have it check for 2 categories, prefers email or requests additional email, so that it can do either post and email, or just post. And then there's a couple other little things that I need to figure out and debug, but it's pretty cool. And then you got this page, which is a work in progress. That's not the one that I wanted. So there are other types of pages. Let's see here. So that doesn't show up. If we go to the bottom of the look on this article, it's work in progress. If we go to AD and Rum Runner, for example, you'll see that it's got this small work in progress, right? It doesn't have the big red banner. It'll work on those too. Control Shift J. Import script. Only instead of showing up as a button, it will show up as a little mark as done. Click on that. And it will actually remove this line. It'll disappear from the page. You won't have to reload it. That's something else that I need to do. But you'll see it removed work in progress number 1 from page. I've been using this as a test. There's actually two different pages. It's work in progress hyphenated like this, or there's actually one, there's a redirect to this that's just WIP. It checks for both of them, and it'll work on either of them. So yeah, good stuff. All right, so we got some archive stuff loaded up here. September 4th, 2015. So let's go here. Now, chop that out, paste it in here. September 4th, 2015. Archived. Paste. While I'm here, it was 30% off, and it was just those two items. Okay. What was that one? September 4th. That's the one I just did. So I already had that one. September 11th, 17th. This row, end. Archived equals this. Back to the beginning. October 9th to the 15th. I'll go through and make sure that the items list is correct. 9th to the 15th. Archived equals this. I'll do that later. All right. There's that one. December 24th to the 7th. End. All right. There were some from 2014 I can go back to. Wait for those to load. Template search, I'll work on that later. That's too much work for me to do in 10 minutes. Template work in progress. You can see what I did here as I added some IDs to the template. Clear. Which allows me to pull it up with the JavaScript and add the buttons. I should make sure that it can't be used on this page. Add that to the script. Let's see here. Can we get three more people to say hi in chat? Talk page, immediate email, both. What was the other thing I was going to do? Anybody remember what I said? Or did I say? Nope, I guess that's a good starting point. Ah, template green. So we have template red, green, blue, gray or gray, orange, purple, and cyan. And then you can go to this one, which has a list of examples. Blue creates blue color text. Cyan creates cyan color. Gray and gray create gray. Green creates green. Orange, purple, and red. This was a feat of marvel in of itself. In a little hide box, you can make it go away if you want. Show the source for that. What's this one right here? DDO store. So that's good. You can see it's a already fine colors, DPL. Category, text color changing templates, include the redirects, order method, sort key, format, give me just a list of titles. And then it creates a table with the header, creates code color text, result, and then it does a loop for I to number of pages in category. It defines the current color as explode the list of colors based on the separator, which is a section symbol, variable I, which is whatever iteration of the loop it is, and then it outputs NoWiki is just a line break. It forces a line break that way. TR style text align center, so align the row centered. Cell TL, whatever the color is. Oh. I actually have that code in there twice, and I don't need it. Jump that. So why did I trim that? Okay, so now it does a loop for whatever number it is, and then it, in the first place where it needs to use the color, it defines it and outputs it. So variable, define, echo means print, explode colors, separator, this instance, creates, I don't need the define one there. It's already going to be defined as a loop index, creates color colored text, close the cell, the next cell shows what it looks like, open template, bar color, creates colored text, close the cell, close the row, end it, end the table, and That doesn't break anything. It doesn't. That's what it does. It creates the header, and then it loops through 8 times, including redirects, blue, cyan, gray, green, orange, purple, red, using the sort key here. Otherwise, gray would be after green. But this one right here, see how it's italic compared to the other ones? That means it's a redirect to gray. It's the same template, just a redirect because of alternate spellings. There you go. Why did I keep this open? Oh, right. That was the other thing I wanted. Okay. Let's see if it's still in my history. MediaWiki gadget. That's what I wanted. Okay, so edit. Full list of redirects to template from API instead of manually defining them, so it not be confused if new redirects are added, e.g. TLWIP with a lowercase p instead of an uppercase p. That's what I wanted to add to the list. All right. Store sales. Ooh, right. Back on that project for a minute. Where was I? January 30th. 2015. So, February 30th, 2015. I want this right here. End. Archived equals this. February 23rd. And archived this. January 17th. 17th. Archived equals this. August 14th. And archived equals this. Okay. Couple in 2014. We'll pull those up. And then we'll get the one from 2013 as well. Ooh, there was more in 2013 than 14. Okay. February 7th, 2014. We don't go back any further than that than data. We don't go back that far. Interesting. So, for sales history row archived equals this. a few more in there. I'll sort them by date after. February 28th. I'll go, yep, that goes above it. Next one is October 31st. Up there, and that was all of them there. October 31, comma 2014, comma 2014. Plus three fate tomes, never seen them in the store. I don't know, I'm sure it's on the page if they've had them. It might be listed as select fate tomes. Or it might be as a special event. Very. February 28, February 21. Okay. Look at those real quick. That was 20% off on over. Oh. Actually, that was the week of November 7th. Wait, what? Why does it say October 31st through November 6th and then November 7th through the 13th? Everybody forgot to update it. Hold on November 12th, so this is the week of November 7th. Somebody goofed when they were making that. That's not October 31st. That's November 7. And it was 20% off. Item 1 equals. That's messy, but okay. Item 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 4. Interesting. Ah, that's why. All right. Wait a minute. I got some 2014s. Oh, I already had those. 7th. At November 7th. Based. Yes. February. Don't have the February stuff in there. February was 20% off. Cats and Homes. Actually, I have that one somewhere. Augments. Jeweler's Toolkits. Augments tools as jeweler's toolkits. Cosmetic armor, hats and helms. Augments and toolkits. Hairs and dyes, we don't have that. You have cosmetics. Now we've got up those November 8th. So those are all DDO sales number 8th. Number 3 something percent. Actually, The other one's back up as well. All right, so that's 11/13, 11/13. They're all the same date. Those ones would be the same. 10th instead of the 13th. There we go. We got a November 1st as well. All right, so let's add one for November 1st. First. November 10th. You've already said hi, man. I need new people to say hi. So we've got August and July. August. What it's doing there. 9th. Buy one. And the other November. Five. That backwards. November 1st is a 25. I got it right. Okay. August 9th, 25%. I can pull up July. July 28th, 20%. Copy. Start here. We have Eberron and Quest XP elixirs with a double S. Typo. Bulls. Augments, augment tools. Medics, okay. So I can pull that one back up. That one's a repeat. Figure out the pattern here. Shared bank item storage, Latin vault, bank item storage. This one, number 8th. Quest XP Elixirs and Eberron Adventure Packs. Right. That one. That. A. A. Missed one. Five, May 11th, 17th. So I got 4 more to go here. Okay. A and A. Fifth. Wow, I'm already 20 minutes over here. I guess we're not doing a drawing today. Aww. And wow, that was a lot of things that week. We're all 20% down there. This is May 11th, so starting at the bottom. Item 3. Four. Five. Six. That one. Oh, you gotta get your friends in here. Get more people. Get your guildies in here. What are friends? Sorry. I meant guildies. Oh, get some. That one's broken because it's case sensitive. Four, five. I think nobody's right on my heels anymore. One. May 31st. The June one left to go. It's June 14th. This one uses the shared bank list. Again. Copy this, sit in here, go preview, there's a lot of stuff there that'll need to be, have links added to it, but that's okay. Pulled some more archives out, I'll have to go through and double check those and confirm that they're correct, or somebody will. You only have one guildie. Yourself? You're in a solo guild? Alrighty. So, I think that wraps up our stream for this week. Oh, you're on Wayfinder. That's right. Get on Discord. Drag people in from Discord. Bribe them and blackmail them. Whatever it takes. So we worked on, what did we work on this week? We commented that out. We did some changes to history row there. We made a change to template edit to allow for creating section links. We populated the data. We remembered that we forgot to remove the work in progress template. So we went through and we removed it automatically with the work in progress script. We removed a small version of the template. We trimmed some redundant code from our category DPL query. Ooh, that should be protected. We made a list on the MediaWiki talk of things to work on. And then we made a massive amount of additions to the sales page. Added some stuff at the top, add some archive links. And added some stuff at the bottom. Awesome. That's what I like to see. I went through and archived all of those, or archived this week's. Somebody else has been archiving those, so I got some more to fill in here. Cool. So I guess I'm going to call that a week then. Check me out on Thursday nights from 9 p.m. until 11 or 12 Eastern. Oh, patterns of the sales. You wanted to know about that. There have been some patterns that have emerged on the discussion page. Analysis of historical data, non-consecutive historical sales. That's not what it was. Changes the sale group over time. There's some patterns there. See how the Hearts of Wood ones have evolved. See some other stuff here. I don't know what this is all about. I'll have to take a look at that. If you go back to the sales page itself, you go to analysis of sales data. There appears to be 12 sales groups that appear about every 3 months, although the actual period can vary between 6 weeks and 6 months. The numbers in this table represent the week each group sales was on sale. See that, you know, week numbers, what the sale was. See it repeats 10 weeks, 12 weeks, 9 weeks. See some repeats in there. I should probably redo this section as well at some point. And then you can see the special sales, like Christmas sale, Thanksgiving sale, 4th of July sale, I think. That month, Christmas, Thanksgiving 2014, stuff in there. Anyway, I'm going to call it a week for the show. Let me bring this up. Have a great week, everybody. We didn't get enough people to do our drawing. I'll save the list, though, and I'll make sure to go in and update the title. We only get two-thirds of the way there, unfortunately. Make sure to hit Discord and any public servers that you can. Maybe post on the forums. Bump the thread that I have. I actually have a thread about the show. If you want to pop on and bump the thread. Let's reset this. I'll quit it after I shut down the stream. That way next week I won't have to start over, reposition it and everything. So yeah, have a great week. Thanks for showing up. Make sure to check me out on Thursday nights for ShoeMaker streams Lord of the Rings Online on twitch.tv/lotrostream. And then on Sunday night, I will be here on DDO stream doing shoe cobbles, and next week is Dwarven Barbarian, which I need to remember to work on this week and level up a little bit. Get some XP ground out for that. All right, have a great week.